office or not. So I contact either the AG or probably the Austria that around the storage. And what kind of industry I need to go in? So I have the list of search results. Actually, I have not only regulatory updates there, but also like what fixes. I want you can see a set of filters on the website. I want to actually uncheck product issues and run search today. So right now, after this, I have only regulatory updates for Austria. Updates with a green line, vertical line is updates which you already released, and with a red line is something on the square. And I can see that, yeah, Microsoft actually knows about that AD is changing the software, right? And claiming the update, and update will come in January 2016. So this is the type of information you can get already now for not only for F7 that you need, but for previous version 2009 and 2012. And even if you want to understand a little bit more detail about what we released, you can click on this and you can go into the more detail, you can download code fix, or you can read the KB article about this change. Yeah, thank you, Mikhail. And last topic before I go on the stage to Luciana, I want to talk about consistency. Previously, with the current version, it's for customers and partners who are deploying and working internationally. It's really not easy to find solutions and localization providers in different countries not covered by Microsoft. And also, when you find this solution, sometimes the quality is not really consistent. And we want, in X7, we want to make it different, and we are doing two main things. One, we will be curating localization solution. We have a set of requirements and process, and Microsoft will be curating or checking the quality of this solution before they are published on Azure Marketplace. And the second thing is what I already mentioned, that we will provide consistent information through the localization portal, through the services we just presented, both for our functionality as well as functionality which we will be provided by our localization providers. So this is all for my side, and I would like to invite Luciana to talk about the IP translation solution.
Translated if you did translation before, you can further train the system with your own materials. And then when you run the machine translation, the results are way more approximate to what you're expecting. It's not, you know, solver. So you expect still a review and post-editing is strongly recommended. It's still machine translation, but it should be way closer to what you are expecting, way closer to the ERP domain. Okay? The second thing is that the ERP translation tool, and that's available to download in LCS, was developed by my team, and basically this is automation for the translation-related tasks. So translation is done in XLIF format for the solution. That's a standard format for an organization. And that the tool has code, like you can run it to convert the AX native source formats into XLIF. You start the process. The tool automates the machine translation run. It automates if you start the translation, it's your own solution, then you get updates to the resources. It handles that as well. You get the translations before, you can use it to reuse translations. So it automates all those common steps, and at the end, it converts back text in files into the AX native resource format so you can load that in the system. Okay? So that's the automation part. And then the last one is an option for translation editor. This one is just optional. I know people work in different, depending on the volumes you're translating, and if you're translating the full product or your solutions, you might be adopting a capital already or have a translation company working for you, or many people were asking us for a translation editor. So the multilingual editor that was released with the multilingual capital team from the Windows International team, it's a good one. It's basic, it's kind of a, it's a simple translation editor, but it works well with XLIF. It connects to the Microsoft Translator Hub. It connects to the Microsoft technology data as well, so you can get some further recycling from Microsoft products. I wouldn't use it, let's say, if you're translating AX as a whole for a new language, but for smaller solutions, if you want something free, pretty straightforward, easy to use. So here's how to sign up in LCS, and the hope to sign up is really because then we see what you're doing. We can give you steps, links to download the tools, more instructions, and most importantly, we can train. It's a language that we produced before. We will train an instance of the Microsoft Translator Hub for you with our materials. So you get started, that's how you're sharing your linguistic assets. So you go to the localization and translation tile there in the LCS. We're keeping all our localization solutions together. Once you click that, you get the two options. Go to the ERP translation solution. And there's this dashboard. For every language pair that you're producing, you have to enter a request. So you're asking about the product, and then what's the country you're targeting, and then your source language, target language. So we can provide instructions and we can train the machine translation system based on the languages that are required. Just submit, and we will be notified. There is a dashboard where we can now see the status of the request. You're going to have access to these visiting status, other resources, you can see the steps that you need to perform. There is a part for comments where you can submit comments or questions to us. You need more support in a touch box. So here you can manage the process, see where we are processing it, but also use it to talk to us directly. Okay? So that's it from my part. We will be here available for questions. We also have a booth at the Microsoft under finance organization